I went in there and I realized that there was a demon in this place.
A ghost hunter gets spooked.
It scared me because it sounded inhuman.
Well, welcome to the 700 Club. For today's top stories, let's go over to the CBN News Desk.
Gordon, after weeks of uncertainty, the Senate finally reached a deal to prevent the United States from going over the fiscal cliff. Although they didn't finish the vote until just after 2 a.m. this morning. The deal does let taxes go up on some high-income Americans, and now the House of Representatives has to take up the plan.
This fiscal deal passed the Senate 89-8.
I think we can say we've done some good for the country.
That's what Minority Leader Mitch McConnell said after hammering out the last-minute deal with Vice President and former Senate colleague Joe Biden. But the House, too, must agree to the deal.
You surely shouldn't predict how the House is going to vote.
The deal will block those Bush-era tax cuts going up on 99% of taxpayers. But taxes will go up on couples making $450,000 and more. That's a lot for House Republicans to swallow, not having passed a bipartisan tax increase since 1990. And they may have been soured by a White House event where President Obama appeared to some Republicans to be gloating over his victory even before the deal was done.
Keep in mind that just last month, Republicans in Congress said they would never agree to raise tax rates on the wealthiest Americans.
He comes out and calls people together and has a group standing behind him, laughs and jokes and ridicules Republicans. Why?
The deal will also put off those painful automatic spending cuts across government for 2 months. It will maintain unemployment benefits for millions of Americans, and it will prevent a hike in the alternative minimum tax for some 28 million other Americans. That is, if the deal can get passed in a House of Representatives. And these days, the House rarely sees eye to eye with the Senate. Meanwhile, tourists outside the majestic Capitol building wondered why those inside were having such a tough time cutting a deal.
I can't for the life of me figure out why they can't make things work. It doesn't make a benefit to anyone. It seems like a family, like squabbling within itself rather than getting to the real point.
Something has gone terribly wrong when the biggest threat to the American economy is the American Congress.
And both liberal and conservative groups don't like the deal, and that may make it tougher for the House to pass it. Same-sex couples in Maryland and Maine moved quickly to take advantage of new state laws allowing them to get married. Same-sex couples in Maine got married just after midnight Saturday when that state's gay marriage law went into effect. And same-sex couples in Maryland also got married as soon as they could, just after midnight, and gay marriage became legal in their state as well. Both states went through long political battles over same-sex marriage before voters in both states approved the laws in November. And a new law is also bringing a new trend in Colorado. The first marijuana clubs have begun popping up there after voters legalized recreational pot smoking. But the Colorado amendment prohibits public marijuana consumption, and that's why some pot smokers headed indoors to Club 64.
Club 64 is a gathering of individuals in a free country who like to exercise their constitutional rights together, which the voters of Colorado wisely gave us. It smells like freedom.
Club 64 gets its name from the number of the amendment. The club opened up near downtown Denver, and about 200 people are already signed up. It costs about $30 to join the Bring Your Own Pot Club. A similar club also reportedly opened in a small southern Colorado town called Del Norte. A federal judge has ruled that a property management company owned by the founder of Domino's Pizza doesn't have to implement mandatory contraception coverage in the healthcare law right away. The judge ruled in favor of Tom Monahan and his Domino's Farm Corporation. Monahan is a devout Roman Catholic, and he says contraception isn't healthcare, but a gravely immoral practice. Well, the world rang in 2013 last night with spectacular fireworks displays, showers of confetti, and other celebrations. And as always, a huge crowd packed into New York's Times Square to greet the new year.
I couldn't believe that, you know, I have such such an amazing woman with me here on New Year's Eve.
This was my first time. It was absolutely incredible.
I love this. I'm really cold, though. It was worth it.
The cold and just going without food, it's so worth it because there's nothing else like it.
Happy New Year!
Americans say that that despite the tough economy, they're hoping for a better new year next year. Well, those are today's top stories from CBN News. Gordon and Terry will be back with more of the 700 Club in just a moment.
Coming up later.
I went in there and I realized that there was a demon in this place.
A ghost hunter gets spooked.
It scared me because it sounded inhuman.
The proof of what she heard.
This is like a real clip of audio.
And how it haunted her.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch, and Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you're tired of stabbing your fingertips to test your blood glucose, we have news that could change your life. The Embrace Meter from Diabetes Care Club is nearly painless. And the best news is that Diabetes Care Club would love to send you one of these meters. Call now to find out why. Nearly 250,000 patients have joined Diabetes Care Club. Membership is free. So is the call.
Call 1-800-935-3114.
Talk to Diabetes Care Club. You'll be glad you did.
Well, Eileen Denny has a thriving medical practice on one of the islands of Hawaii. Sounds like paradise, and it is now. But not long ago, Dr. Denny was struggling just to pay the bills.
Eileen Denny has been a cancer doctor for over 30 years. Her oncology practice has helped thousands of patients across the United States.
I was successful, very busy, but successful and in solo practice, making a good income, and was able to provide and even save in the bank account for rainy day.
Her rainy day came in 1998. Her father had been diagnosed with cancer. Eileen moved to Hawaii to care for him and her mother. Just 2 months after she arrived, her father passed away. She decided to stay in Hawaii and set up her oncology practice, but she had few patients and a lot of overhead.
I didn't know the medical community. Usually in oncology, you need referrals, and I wasn't getting the patients. So for 5 years, I wasn't even making overhead. I couldn't pay the bills, not really. And I saw the savings just go down and down, my income not going up.
But as a Christian, Eileen believed she needed to be faithful to tithing, even in the midst of her financial crisis.
I like to obey the word, and it talks about tithing, giving 10%. And it's just something in my spirit that I feel is the right thing, because my money is not my money. Whatever I earn, it comes from God. So 10% is a small amount.
But the pressure from her financial situation still weighed heavily on Eileen.
I remember at one moment just crying out to God, help me, Lord. I cannot carry this house. I can't carry the bills with what income I have.
Shortly after her prayer, she had a breakthrough. She was invited to join a team of doctors at a clinic on the island of Kauai. Today, her oncology practice is thriving.
My finances have been restored and more. God is so faithful. And I've lived long enough, I'm in my 60s, that I can see over and over and over that He is so faithful. And when I'm going through whatever trial it is at this time, I just claim that promise and I stand firm on it, that He is faithful.
And what He's done, Eileen, He'll do for you. He is faithful. Here's the promise, and it's the only time in the Bible where we get to test God. It's in Malachi chapter 3, verse 10. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And prove me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing, that there will not be room enough to receive it. Well, that promise is available to you today. All you have to do is, on the first part of it, activate it and say, I'm going to tithe, I'm going to give. And then you get the great principle. It's one of the principles of the universe, the law of reciprocity. Give, and it will be given unto you. Terry?
Well, the birth of a child is supposed to be a happy time. But when baby Annie's father first saw her, he actually considered killing himself, and you're about to see why.
Little baby Annie was born with a cleft lip. She's Douglas and Anna's only child. At the hospital, a doctor told them to schedule surgery right away for the baby, but they could not afford it.
When I look at her on the bed, I would begin to cry. I asked God to heal her, to send someone and operate on the child.
Douglas's reaction was even more heartbreaking.
I was so distressed. I would cry, and at times, the idea of killing myself came into my mind.
One day, Anna saw a flyer for Operation Blessing, which was offering free cleft lip and palate surgeries. Anna applied, and a few days later, Operation Blessing called.
I was so happy. It was a miracle. I was not expecting it at all.
Baby Anna's surgery was successful, and just a few days later, we went back to see how the young family was doing.
I feel so grateful to those who helped our little girl. They are wonderful.
I'm grateful that my daughter has a new smile and hope for the future. Thank you.
You know, here in America, if a baby is born with a cleft lip, cleft palate, it is surgically corrected almost immediately. But in other parts of the world, families don't have the money to do this. Even though it's not really incredibly expensive, they simply don't have the money, nor do they have the ability to even save for it. They're scraping by just to make a living, just to survive. So this poor little family was desperate. We see this all the time around the world, and where we can, where it's possible, we do come in and make a change like was made in baby Annie's instance. She will have a smile for the rest of her life. She'll be accepted by people. She'll be able to hold a job because she can speak correctly. She'll be able to eat without any problem. All of that happened because people like you care. You cared enough to make a difference. 700 Club members are doing that every day all around the world. If you're not a 700 Club member, join with the rest of us. The power of one person to make a difference is immeasurable. Be one of those people who says, I want to be a world changer. You can do that by joining the 700 Club. A general 700 Club membership is 65 cents a day, $20 a month, and we welcome you to the family of ministries here, reaching out to the world with the love of Jesus Christ. You join with us by calling that toll-free number that you see on your screen. It's 1-800-759-0700. When you join, will you use something we call Pledge Express? It means your bank does all the work. You don't have any of the hassle, don't have to remember anything, but it saves us in processing costs so we can put even more of your gift directly into the lives of children like baby Annie. And our way of saying thank you for using Pledge Express is to send you Power for Life teachings. You'll get one of these each month. You'll love them. They'll bless your life, and you'll know you're making a difference in someone else's. Gordon?
Well, up next, her husband took an interest in a woman online. So this wife took up an interest of her own.
I was a medium and communicating with spirits. So I got on the internet and I searched ghost hunting groups in my area.
Watch what happened when this ghost hunter was spooked by her prey. Up next.
Come on, give me that. Bye. Sure, life is busy, but I found a way to make a huge difference in people's lives. I guess you could say I'm changing the world right here from home. I bring medical supplies and doctors to people in need.
and dig wells so that villagers can have clean and safe water to drink. I make it possible to preach the gospel in over 100 countries, including right here in America. And when disaster strikes, I'm there, providing food, thank you, and emergency supplies to give people hope again. Every day, CBN and I are making the world a better place. Here you go. My life is hectic, so I joined CBN through Pledge Express. My bank does all the work, and I know that my gift is being used where it's needed most. So become a CBN partner and join Pledge Express, because you can do a world of good right from where you are. Hi, good morning. Are you ready to get started?
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. Invent helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how Invent Help may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
After her husband had an online affair, Christine McGuire developed an interest of her own, ghost hunting. But one night, Christine caught her prey on tape, and she got the scare of her life.
Christine McGuire was deeply involved in the occult and ghost hunting. But one night, she realized she was in way over her head.
I went in there, and it was a very active night. We had some very strange things happen. And I realized that there was a demon in this place.
Even though she was a full-fledged witch, Christine still considered herself a Christian. Her husband, Tom, explains.
She had blended Christianity with witchcraft, which we've now come to know as a term as syncretism, which is taking different religions and blending them together.
Basically, I just ignored what the Bible said in certain parts and read the rest of it to be what I wanted it to mean and folded it into witchcraft.
Christine was raised in a Christian home, but when she and Tom started having problems in their marriage, they questioned their faith.
That's when things started to kind of fall apart in our marriage and in our relationship with God.
After Tom had an emotional affair with a woman online, he and Christine separated.
I felt abandoned by God. I didn't have control over my own destiny. And I wanted to connect with a feminine energy. I wanted to connect with a goddess. And so I felt that feminine energy. I think that's why I was so drawn to it, because it appealed to me as a woman.
Over the next 5 years, Christine dove deeper into witchcraft. But she couldn't shake the feeling that God was trying to get her attention.
The Holy Spirit, he just prodded me from day one. He would, I'd say he was poking me with a stick, you know, trying to help me to come to my senses. Because, you know, I knew what I was doing was wrong, but I chose to ignore that.
She eventually started ghost hunting.
By that time, I was a medium and communicating with spirits on my own, and I was watching this going, oh, I could do that. So I got on the internet and I searched ghost hunting groups in my area.
At the same time, Tom rededicated his life to God and tried to reconcile with Christine.
I called and told her that I thought we ought to get back together, that God had a greater plan than what we had.
We were reunited, and he knew I was a ghost hunter, a medium, and a witch.
So I decided this time I would just kind of go with the flow, and I would pray for her a lot and just kind of be that pillar for her.
Christine refused to change, but one night she realized that her choices could have severe consequences.
I realized that there was a demon in this place. At one point, I felt like I should command the spirit to leave in the name of Jesus. There was an authority that I hadn't used in years.
In the name of Jesus, you are gonna leave. You're uninvited. Now he's gonna go where Jesus sends him.
The interesting thing was, we didn't hear anything happen at that time. But a few days later, I got an email with a file attached to it that had an EVP on it, an electronic voice phenomenon. And it happened to be the clip from when I told this spirit it had to leave in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus, you are gonna leave. You're uninvited. Now he's gonna go where Jesus sends him and not come back.
And what you hear is what can only be described as a scream. It was the strangest thing I've ever heard. It scared me, to be quite honest. Because it sounded inhuman. I had just heard a demon react to the true, honest power of Jesus' name. I sent the file to my husband.
Being an audio engineer, I took it into my laptop and I looked at it in the waveforms to see, okay, who edited this and, you know, where's the edit happen? And it's not there. So this is like a real clip of audio. And so it really freaked her out. And she started realizing that there was power in Jesus' name. And he wasn't just, you know, a good guy that she should listen to, but that he was the Son of God.
Christine knew then that she could never combine witchcraft and spiritualism with Christianity.
I realized that I had been fooled. I'd given myself over to demons. And it was at that moment that I literally got down on my face and just poured my heart out to the Lord and begged for his forgiveness. And I renounced everything that I had been involved in.
Tom knew that God had answered him.
I believe in the power of prayer. And so I figured that just praying a lot, eventually things would turn around. I had faith that God could do it.
That meant more to me than anything, to know that my husband, he just accepted me where I was at that time, and loved me enough to trust me to God's hands.
Today, she warns others about the dangers of the occult.
You might not necessarily be involved or even dabbling in magic or ghost hunting or anything like that, but you start reading about it, you start watching television programs, you start watching movies, searching on the internet. And so I think probably the most important thing I would say is read the Bible and understand the power that is behind these things in the occult, because it's a very real power. It's very real, and its only intent is our spiritual destruction. I'm so thankful and grateful for God pulling me out of that deception and out of that life of harassment that I didn't even realize I was living. There is nothing like the power of Jesus. The power of Jesus, it saves, it forgives, it loves. Jesus is everything.
It's resurrection power. It redeems things that are long lost, deeply lost. God's power is amazing. You know, so often people get into just exploring some of the things Christine was into because they feel out of control in their situation. They feel powerless with some of the things that are happening to them. They search for a place where they can control. Don't mess around with things like this. God is real, and there is a true enemy of God. There is a devil. There are demons. There is a dark world that you and I are not meant to explore. We were created to live in a garden with God forever. You can have a deep relationship with God today. He wants to love you. He wants to know you. He is able to provide everything that you need, but the power is His, not yours, not mine. It's His. You saw as Christine was reading the word, it said, man cannot serve two masters. You can't, and God is jealous for you. He's jealous for you today because he loves you so much. That's why one of the commandments is, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. Today, God wants to love you back. He wants you to know his love. He's got purposes and plans that are being walked out all around us every day, and he invites you and I to be a part of that. But you can't serve two masters. Today, will you renounce any of the things you've been involved in that have been outside of the realm and the will and the power of God? Anything that you've attached yourself to, looking for answers in all the wrong places, looking for love in all the wrong places. Come home to the heart of Jesus today. That's why he came. It's why he died, to set you free. He said we would know the truth, and it was the truth that would set us free. And then he said, I am the truth. Come to Jesus today. Don't settle for second best. Don't settle for a counterfeit. Come to the one who loved you enough to give everything he had for you. Will you pray with me right now? Let's just invite Jesus into our hearts and lives and renounce anything that would separate or divide us from him. Pray with me. Lord, I want to know you today. I admit that in my frustration, in my impatience, in my fear and anxiety, I have looked to other things for my peace, for my power, for my joy, for my sense of meaning in life, and I just want to renounce all of those things today. I renounce any involvement in the occult. I renounce drug usage. I renounce dependency on anything other than you, Lord, and I ask you, Jesus, to come into my heart today to forgive my sins. All of them, God. From the smallest to the largest, you know everyone. I am confessing it all to you today and saying, I am so sorry. I'm asking you for a new beginning, not because I deserve it, but because you are merciful, God. Today, will you be the Savior of my soul and the Lord of my life? Come in, Jesus, to the very core of me. Teach me your ways. As I read the Bible, open it up to me. Open the eyes and the ears of my understanding so I can know you, so I can hear you when you speak to my heart. I want to be set free. I want the gift of eternal life that you offer. I receive that today. Thank you, Father, for loving me, for hounding me, for waiting for me, for making a plan and a purpose for my tomorrow as well as for my today. I receive it all today in Jesus' name. Amen. If you've prayed that prayer, there are steps that you need to take to help your spiritual life grow, and we've put together a little packet just for you. It's called The New Day, and it's filled with information from the Word of God. Also, Pat's put together a DVD for you. What do you do now that you've prayed this prayer? How do you grow in your relationship with Jesus? This is completely free. So is the phone call. It's 1-800-759-0700. Just call and say, I prayed that prayer and I'd like the New Day packet. We'll get that out to you right away. And if you've been delving into the occult, we've got a great little brochure we'd love to share with you. Tells you what the Bible has to say about it. It's called Angels, Demons, and the End Times, and we'll send this to you for free as well. Just indicate that you'd like it when you call. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club, so stay with us.
Coming up later, a cowboy with a Texas-sized addiction.
I never was a guy who could, have a drink.
And a monster hangover.
It's like you hit me right in the forehead with a chopping axe.
How he got on the wagon for good.
They think I must have snorted something up my nose or something. Went crazy.
I didn't understand what love was. I didn't have a good example. I knew of God, and I often would think to myself, God, if you're real, help me in this situation. I told the Lord, I said, God, I don't have anything to offer you. It's just me and my little baby, and I don't have anything together. I had peace. It was so refreshing. He loves you so much that he died for you. And if he can do all of this in my life, he can do it for you.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
Call 1-800-284-4105. We will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
And welcome back to the 700 Club. The president of Nigeria says the church is one of the main targets of terrorist attacks by the radical Islamist group Boko Haram. He told parishioners at a church in Nigeria's capital Sunday, if the idea of Boko Haram is to stop Nigerians from worshiping God, they will not succeed. Gunmen suspected of belonging to Boko Haram attacked a Nigerian village in the last few days. They rounded up men, women, and children and killed at least 15. The Christian Association of Nigerian Americans wants the United States to label Boko Haram a foreign terrorist organization. That could hurt its funding and support. Thousands of young Christians who finished 2012 at the Urbana Student Missions Conference are starting the new year with commitments to serve God as missionaries. Urban Director Tom Lin says more than 4,000 of the 16,000 students who attended the five-day conference in St. Louis committed to more than 2 years of missionary service in their lives. Lin says they accepted the challenge to both proclaim the gospel and to demonstrate Christian love through service into those in need. And he says planning will start soon for the next Urbana Student Missions Conference in 2015. As always, you can get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com. Gordon and Terry will be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
Finding video on cbn.com just got easier. We've taken all our video, the 700 Club, news, testimonies, teachings, plus our 24/7 channels, and put them in one convenient location, CBN TV. Watch what you want, when you want. It's all simple to find, and now easier than ever to email a story to a friend. CBN TV on CBN.com.
Dear Bowflex, I dropped 8 dress sizes, 36 pounds, and all I had to do was walk.
This is the Bowflex Trek Climber Machine, the easiest way to walk and burn up to 3.5 times the calories. By combining the motion of a treadmill, a stepper, and an elliptical, you get the calorie-burning benefits of all 3 workouts at once.
I lost 30 pounds in 4 months. If I can do it, anyone can do it.
Call now for your free DVD and information kit. You'll see how the Trek Climber burns up to 3.5 times the calories of a treadmill. Right now, you can own a Trek Climber machine today and get special financing for 18 months.
Within the first couple of weeks, I started to lose inches. I lost 50 pounds in 3 months using the Trek Climber. I lost 150 pounds in such a short period of time. All my friends are like, how did you do it?
To look better and feel younger, call or go online to buytc.com for your free DVD and information kit today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bowflex.
Sincerely, J.D. Weber.
Steve didn't need a party for an excuse to get drunk. Any time would do. Then one morning he woke up with the mother of all hangovers. So he decided to have a little talk with Jesus.
Working as a horse auctioneer isn't just a job for Steve Friscup. It's a passion. He also loves calf roping and spending time with his wife, Robin. But years ago, Steve's favorite activities were overshadowed by his love for alcohol.
I never was a guy who could, like, have a drink and then go home. If I had one, I was going to have two. If I had two, I was going to have 12. And if I had 12, then sometime in the night I was going to become rich, handsome, and bulletproof all at the same time.
Steve had his first drink when he was just 9 years old. His parents went to church, but they were heavy drinkers. As an adult, Steve discovered alcohol gave him something he had always longed for.
It made me liked. It made me popular. It made me fit in. And I may not can rope as good as anybody. I may not have as much money as anybody else. But when we're at the bar, you're going to like me. However much it costs, you're going to like me.
But the alcohol didn't just make Steve popular. It turned him into a man he barely knew.
It just dumbed me down to a guy that I didn't want to be. Every time I sobered up, I didn't want to be that guy. That's not who I wanted to be. And I knew it.
His poor judgment spilled over into his marriage.
But I could spend money on the dumbest stuff. I could buy drinks for everybody. You know, you could gamble. You could just do what, you know, buy stuff. Just do dumb stuff.
Steve's drinking affected his relationship with his children the most.
I used language that was a man should be crucified for in front of my children. I wasn't mean and abusive. I was just vulgar. Stuff like that. It's no good.
One morning after a night of drinking, Steve woke up with his usual hangover and a revelation. He was tired of his drunken lifestyle.
And I got up that morning and had to go to work. And I was sick, with capital sick. I mean, it was bad. It was like you hit me right in the forehead with a chopping axe. I didn't have any money left. And I laid there in that bed and I thought, now I got to put my game face on and go auctioneer this horse sale and pretend like I'm fine. And I'm not fine. And I told that friend of mine, I said, I ain't drinking no more. I'm done. Oh, they kidded me. He told everybody. They laughed at me. They picked on me all weekend.
But Steve was serious about his new commitment. He just didn't know how to keep it. On the ride home after the auction, he decided to talk to God.
That night, I called on Jesus for some odd reason. I did that. Nobody's told me how to pray this prayer. I just called on Jesus, and I met him. He said, what do you want? I said, I want two things. I want to be a good husband, and I want to be a good dad. And I don't want to do another thing away from home that I'm ashamed to tell my family when I get back. And alcohol's turning me loose to be an idiot, and I don't want it anymore. I want rid of it right now. He said, if you'll give me all of it, I'll get rid of that. And I said, I'm all yours. And it moves me every time how awesome it is for a guy like me in the cab of a pickup to have your sins forgiven.
He drove home that night and started a new life. He started reading his Bible and going to church with his family.
It was pretty amazing when you pull in your house and you tell your family, get up, we're going to go to church. I just got saved. And you don't even know what that means. You know, they think you must have snorted something up my nose or something. Went crazy. You know, the guy wants to go to church.
Steve says he hasn't had a drop of alcohol since.
The fear of the Lord will make a man hate evil. And as I've grown to fear the absence of God in my life, fear disappointment in God, and I've got to where I just despise evil. And I've gotten that away about the alcohol because it was so dangerous in my life and I didn't know it. Jesus saved me on the side of that road, signified it by putting his spirit in me. He forgave my sin and he gave me a chance to become Christ-like.
He'll give you that same chance. He's no respecter of persons. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. And the amazing thing is that he died for you, just for you. If you were the only one to ever believe, he still would have come just for you. You're that important to him. He loves you that much. He doesn't want to spend another moment without you. That is the good news. The good news that we need to tell everyone. you know, how important you are to God. And whether you're in the cab of a pickup or sitting right now at home, all you have to do is ask him. Now, what did Steve ask? He said, I just want to be a good husband and a good father. And if you can do that, can you do that for me? Jesus answered, if you give me all of it, if you give me all of it. That's the key. Don't have secret parts of your life, parts that God doesn't have. Give him all of it. You can trust him with it. He's the one that created you. And he's created you for good things. He's created you for joy. He's created you to have things that will satisfy your innermost being. He's created all of that for you. The Bible says that before the foundation of the earth, before the heavens were rolled out, before all of that, he was thinking about you. And he was thinking that you're going to have plans and a future and a hope and good things to walk into. Now, that's an amazing God. That's an amazing story. And all you have to do is ask for it. That's all you have to do. Now, do you have to hit bottom like Steve did? No. You have to wake up and say, I hate what I've become? No. You can do it right now. The Bible says, when you seek me with all of your heart, then you'll find me. And if you ask him, he'll come. If you ask him to speak to you, he'll speak. If you ask him to show up, he'll show up. He is God with us. He is Emmanuel, not far away, but right there with you right now. For in him we live and move and have our being. Now, if this is you, if right now you say it's time for me to get right with God, right now, bow your head, say a very simple prayer, and God will do all the rest. Pray with me. Jesus. That's right. Say it out loud. Jesus. And just talk to him because he's right there with you right now. Jesus. I open my heart to you. And I don't want to keep anything back. I give it all. I give it all to you. And I ask that you come in, that you make me new again, that you give me a new heart, a new beginning. And Jesus, I ask that you fill me with your Spirit and change me. And if you'll do this, I want to follow you all the days of my life. Hear my prayer, for I pray it in Jesus' name. Father, for those who just prayed, I ask for a baptism in your love. Let them know just how much their prayer has been heard and has been answered, and how they're accepted now in your family. Let them feel your presence, Lord. Open their ears so they can hear your voice. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed with me, the Bible says that all you have to do now is just confess with your mouth. Let somebody know that that's what you've done. Bible's real clear. If you confess me before men, I'll confess you before my Father. So what I want you to do is make a toll-free call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, I prayed with that guy on TV. I asked Jesus into my heart. And I want to let somebody know I did that. When you call, we've got a packet for you. It's called A New Day. And here's a wonderful CD teaching. What do you do now? How do you live the Christian life? There's also a booklet with Bible verses. We encourage you to get a copy of the Bible. Start reading it every day. Start with the Gospel of John. It's through the reading of the Word, you renew your mind. We also encourage you to join a local church. go through water baptism. All of that is part of what it means to be a Christian. But start with that phone call. Make it right now. 1-800-759-0700. Terry, over to you.
Well, up next, a mom gives birth to miracle twins, but then she needs a miracle herself.
This is a healthy, vibrant young lady who was just dying in the other room. There were four good doctors in that room, and each one of us thought the same thing was going to happen.
See how this patient surprised the experts when we come back.
Brenda, you got to see the video I saw on the 700 Club. I pray God will do the same awesome work in your life.
Go to CBN.com to I Saw It on the 700 Club for a fast, easy way to see and share your favorite videos.
Life can be tough. There are challenges for all of us. Jesus told us to pray for one another, and that's exactly what we want to do. On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to bring Christians together to pray for each other, meet others just like you, and talk or share with them in real time. Watch God work miracles in people's lives. Be part of 700 Club Interactive, weekdays at 9:30 on ABC Family.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Well, the mom in our next story had a difficult pregnancy, but she didn't mind. You see, the twin boys she was carrying were an awesome answer to prayer. So when they were born, she expected to have the worst of it behind her. Instead, she got the fight of her life.
Wes and Kim Funk had always hoped for children, but doctors told them it was impossible. But after years of prayer, Kimberly became pregnant with what doctors called miracle twins.
It was very exciting. I was probably the most gleeful dad. Here we are being blessed with children, the opportunity to have twins.
It was kind of a tough pregnancy. I was sick a lot, but it was such a blessing to be pregnant that, you know, you didn't want to focus on all the negatives. So every week was just such a blessing. We're that much closer.
On July 17th, 1994, Kim gave birth to two twin boys, Kyle and Corey. Although they were 6 weeks premature, the boys were healthy.
I have absolutely no recollection of my babies being born. And there were signs there that I was going downhill. It's just no one had diagnosed what's going on yet.
Just days later, Kim suddenly had severe abdominal pain.
The next day, Kim was kind of delirious, and it alarmed me, and I would question the nurses and doctors.
Kim was whisked off for testing. CAT scans confirmed the presence of gallstones and inflammation in her gallbladder. Kim was taken into the OR to have her gallbladder removed, a common procedure that usually takes less than an hour.
Three and a half hours went by. The doctors finally walked into the door, and their heads were bowed. They basically were telling me that she had a 5% chance of living.
During surgery, doctors were shocked to find that Kim had acute pancreatitis and a blood clot in her lungs. Her kidneys and liver were also failing. She was in a coma and put on a respirator.
I know, and I could see it in their faces, that they even felt that there were so many complications that they didn't even know all the answers. And my emotions were just all over the place. And clutching Kim's Bible, I would go to the chapel and pray, God, you can't let her pass away and leave me behind with these two boys. She completes the family. We have these children because of our love for one another. you gave us this miracle of children. I now need another miracle. I need a miracle for Kim to stay here. Please answer my prayers. No matter how much the doctors would tell me, I still felt I had to believe something else, and prayer was what got me through this.
Other friends and family members started prayer chains that snowballed into countless groups praying for Kim around the globe. Even Kim's doctor prayed for his patient.
I'll never forget my first meeting with her husband, Wes, and that I came into the ICU, and the first thing he says, "You have to save my beautiful wife, doctor." And this is a healthy, vibrant young lady who was just dying in the other room. There's no other way to describe it except that. And I felt powerless. So I went home that night, and my wife could sense that I was a little bit concerned, and so we talked about it. I told her the whole scenario, and Suzanne said, "This is something we have to specifically pray for Kimberly. We have to specifically pray for her, ask for a specific intervention on the part of the Lord." And so we did.
But as Dr. Mullins returned the next day, Kim's condition was worse. Dr. Mullins decided a final high-risk surgery was one of his last options.
The time was right around 10:45 when we started moving her to the operating room.
The moment Dr. Mullins' scalpel penetrated Kim's abdominal wall, a flood of fluid rushed from Kim's body. Kim had undergone a rapid decompression of her abdomen.
When you release that, the pressure goes down and you never get these people back. There were four good doctors in that room, and each one of us thought the same thing was going to happen.
But suddenly, Kim's body did the opposite of what everyone expected.
She had shown a complete reversal from what we thought we were going to see. By the time Monday rolled around, she was off the ventilator. Her liver functions were back to normal. Her kidney functions were back to normal. She had no arrhythmia problems. She had no more pulmonary problems. And she came out of the coma with no problems whatsoever. It happened exactly as we asked the Lord to do it. And that had a profound effect on me.
Several days later, Kim was able to see her boys for the first time. On August the 10th, Wes and Kim, Kyle and Corey, were all at home.
It was overwhelming. I don't know how to even describe, as I heard more and more people that had prayed for me. And I would not be here if people didn't pray for me. I mean, it's so clear that God used this as a moment to say, look at what I can do.
He clearly was the healer here. He clearly did all the magnificent miracles.
Today, 16 years later, everyone in the family is happy and healthy and still celebrating the miracle that God gave them years ago.
There's not a day or a morning I wake up that I don't thank God for answering our prayers, not just my prayers, but all the others worldwide that prayed for Kim. Keep your faith. The odds were against her, but a miracle happened in that OR room. Her body did totally the opposite of what medical textbook says. That's the power of prayer.
A miracle happened in that OR room, and a miracle can happen for you today because we love and serve a miracle working God. We want to pray for you right now, and we want to build your faith by sharing with you some answers to prayer that others have experienced in addition to the story you just heard about Kimberly.
All right, here's Deborah from Douglasville, Georgia. She fell and damaged three discs in her lower back. She said the pain felt like she was being struck with a knife. Her doctor recommended surgery, but she decided against it. Then last April, she was watching the 700 Club. Terry, you had this word of knowledge. You have a tremendous problem with your lower spine. It's like where it sits on the girdle of your hips. It's just so painful. It's excruciating. God is touching and healing that for you right now. Well, Deborah knew the word of knowledge was for her, and since that day, she's been pain-free, and that is a miracle.
That is a miracle. Well, this is Kathy. She lives in Happy Valley, Oregon. You gotta love that. This was in 1995. She couldn't sleep and became severely depressed. She even tried to commit suicide, she said. Her doctor diagnosed her as bipolar and put her on medications that he said she would have to take for the rest of her life. The medicines helped somewhat. They did not cure the condition. Last January, she was watching this program and praying, Lord, please let Gordon say mental illness. Please let him say bipolar. At that moment, Gordon, you said, there's someone saying, please say mental illness. Please say bipolar. And God's healing you now in Jesus' name. Kathy said immediately she felt a warmth and a tingling come all over her body. She stopped taking her meds. When she kept her next doctor's appointment, he confirmed that she did not need them anymore. She had been healed.
That is a miracle. Just imagine how big God is. You know, start thinking about how big is possible. When God says all things are possible to them that believe, you can literally take a medical situation that all the textbooks say it's only going to turn out this way. And God says, well, with me, that's possible. With me, I can turn that around. With me, I can take the incurable and cure it. Well, I like to tell people, you can never be too dead for a resurrection. I don't care what the doctors say. Let's start believing God and how big he is and how big that possible is for you today. Let's pray. Lord, we just lift the needs of the audience to you right now. And for those crying out, for those wondering, hoping, can this be for me? Can Jesus be for me? Together, we just come in agreement with them and say, yes, he came for you. And by his stripes, you are healed and made whole. Now, in Jesus' name. There's someone with a nerve condition. It's throughout your body. It causes false signals of pain. And it's just destroyed your life. God's healing that right now. You're just feeling a warmth and almost like a blanket coming over you right now. And your nerves are being restored. All the connections are being healed. And in Jesus' name, you're healed and made whole. There's someone, you have an inoperable tumor in your brain. It's along the middle of your skull at the top, and it goes over both lobes. God is healing that. He's taking that away now. You just felt a pressure release in your brain, and that headache is leaving you right now. In Jesus' name, be healed, be made whole now. Terry.
There's someone else. You've been diagnosed with stomach cancer. You have a sharp pain from time to time, but it's this gnawing, drawing feeling that you just can't ever get rid of. God is healing that for you right now. You're just going to feel like a warmth in your stomach, and it's going to just be a good warmth. It's going to feel wonderful as he heals you. Someone else, you have really severe fibromyalgia, and you also have in the jaw of your face this pain in your jaw that's been so hard. You just rock and it aches. God is touching you and releasing that and healing it now in Jesus' name.
The problems in the mandible on your right jaw, God's healing it now for you right now in Jesus' name. Amen. If you've been touched by God, we want to share in your good report. We're always here for you. It's our honor to pray for you. So call us, 1-800-759-0700. Hear these words from Matthew. Whatever things you ask in prayer, you will receive.
Hi, I'm Terry Musin. I'd like to tell you about Orphans Promise. Orphans Promise helps children who've had tragic beginnings in life.
My father died, my mother started drinking, and gave me away to the orphanage.
We were homeless, and she made me beg for food.
We don't know where our sister is. I'm looking for her now.
We want to return to be with our mother, but she doesn't want us.
In many countries, children are turned out of orphanages when they turn 16. They lose the only security they've ever known. Many will become easy prey for prostitution rings and criminal gangs. Together, you and I can break this cycle for these kids. For just $20 a month, you'll provide computer training, life skills, and people that care, preparing them for a future of hope. Show them God's love. Call the number on your screen right now and say you'll help.